gym. My guy, New York Style Boxing, Ralphie, all over known. Come on, I know you got some of the crazy. This is a throwback trainer right here, knows everybody.
From the 80s.
From the 80s. You was in the gym with Tyson, right?
Was in the gym in Times Square.
You was in
Ringside.
Also, you was in Kronk, right?
In Kronk, yeah, in Detroit back in the day.
Tell us your craziest Mike Tyson story.
The craziest Mike Tyson story, I met him in 1983 in Times Square gym. I remember he brought his heavy bag with him to upstairs in the gym at the time. At the time, it was a lot like he brought his own sparring partners. That was the most craziest thing in my life I ever went
to. Kelly,
come
in here. He's telling his craziest Mike Tyson story. We got Eric Kelly in the building, too. Yeah. Go ahead, keep telling that Mike Tyson story.
I met Mike Tyson in 1983 in Times Square gym. The craziest story of my life, I met him when he brought his own heavy bag to the gym up on the upstairs floor.
He brought his own heavy bag?
He brought his own heavy bag. He brought his own heavy bag to the gym. When Kevin Rooney was there, was doing at the gym there. And at the time, that gym was no joke because the ring was old school canvas at the time. You had to sign up to do sparring at that time. And Mike had his own sparring partners with a crew cut hair back in the day. Mm. You know, he had his own era, man. It was a great time, me knowing him. At the time, it was a 15-round gym in that era. Today, the whole game has changed now. It ain't the same like it was back in the day. Mm. I mean, I really do interviews nowadays. I just post a lot on Instagram. And those that know me, follow my work. So I'm still around. New York is still where it's at. This is the home of Mecca of boxing.
So what Mike told you when you was playing?
He has a talk show now. Go look up, he has a podcast on YouTube now. Mm-hmm. You know,
I know you were telling me Mike liked Public Enemy a lot.
Oh, he's a Public Enemy man. He said without Public Enemy, he can't train and spar in that gym. He couldn't spar without Public Enemy.
Yeah, he's played Public Enemy
a lot. He is Public Enemy a lot. He'll Fight the Power was one of his best songs back in the day. It was a good thing back then.
So you like the old school hip hop?
Oh yeah, I'm old school. I like N.W.A. I like Public Enemy, Run D.M.C. And, you know, Wu-Tang. You know, P.E. era.
So what else Mike told you? What's the crazy sparring story?
Oh my God, man! Spar with no headgear.
Spar with no headgear.
Headgear couldn't fit in his head back in the day because his head, his neck was so thick. Mm. It was an amazing story back then. It was something I'll never forget about in my life.
Did you ever see Eric Kelly back in the days when he was a youngin'?
Well, he was a young man back then. He's a George Washington. He's best tie man.
Okay.
That's a fact.
Best tie brother, man.
So,
it's very rare to see old guys. A lot of the old cats in the school is hard to find nowadays. You don't really see me in old timers no more.
How good was he?
Eric was good. He was one of the best school guys but George Washington. I gotta respect him. Mm. Even though he's well known as he's a comedian boxing trainer. He's a comedian boxing trainer over on the next. He should be doing stand up, but you're a gym owner now. You're shining. You're doing good, but you got to push it.
You know Eric for Andre Ward?
Oh no, he's Andre Ward. He's well known, man. Eric is well known, but the game has changed now. It's a total different era now.
Let me ask you this. Can any heavyweight today stand a chance against Prime Mike Tyson?
No, no way. The speed, the power, and the lateral movement Mike has is right here. The millennials don't have it.
What you think? Any heavyweight today, could they stand a chance against Mike Tyson?
Today?
Anthony Joshua, Deontay Wilder, can any of them get in the ring with Tyson?
I don't think, not really. If anybody, it'll be Wilder.
Wilder.
I think, if anybody be Wilder. Mentally, Wilder is the more reminiscent of Tyson. Mm. I think Tyson put fear in Joshua. And I'm not gonna say run through Joshua. Probably run through Joshua.
Deontay Wilder reminds me
of Wilder is also a little, you know what I'm saying, about it, yeah. Like Mike was. And
So you see, Wilder has like that killer in him.
To me, Deontay Wilder reminds me of a big, heavy, long-range, heavyweight Tommy Hearns type guy.
Yeah.
He has that lead. He just relies on that right hand. That's right. How he knocked out Tyson and dropped Tyson
at
Fury.
Joshua and look at Frank Bruno.
Okay.
Joshua's the better boxer than Bruno, better fighter than Bruno. You know what I'm saying? But both heavyweight champ of the world, both like Cotton Diesel, both from the UK.
He reminds me of a big long range Tommy Hearns type fighter of the 80s. So you know he's good. He's a good heavyweight. He hasn't been tested yet.
Talk to me about welterweights. Can any of today's welterweights, Keith Thurman, Errol Spence, Sean Porter, could they take on...
Terrence Crawford.
Could they take on Sugar Ray Leonard, Tommy Hearns?
That'll be hard to say. There'll be a good test on that. I don't even think it'll get past Aaron Pryor. Aaron Pryor, get the mix in there. Aaron Pryor, Wilfredo Benitez, you know, Esteban De Jesus. These guys, those guys were gladiators. You know, forget about Duran. Duran is one of the top fighters of all time. Don't forget about those guys in the 80s. The 80s were one of the top eras in the welterweight division that will be top of all time.
So let me ask the fantasy fight for my last question.
Only Floyd Mayweather.
Ooh, that's what I want to get into.
Floyd Mayweather wouldn't even test those guys out.
So you already answered
it. It's Floyd Mayweather tactics,
whatever, versus whatever. Sugar Ray Leonard.
I say Leonard.
Leonard
wow. Be his father. Leonard okay. Be Roger Mayweather. So
He'd be Floyd Mayweather Senior. Yeah.
I mean, Floyd may be better at defensive tactics, but that defense could be breaking into easily. You know, Jose Luis Castillo beat him, and he had to rematch him.
Okay.
I think Jose Luis Castillo beat him. Castillo was the closest guy that beat him, and I think he won, and he had to rematch him.
Everybody, right there, New York style boxing. Where can everybody follow you?
NYC style and New York style boxing on Instagram.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Right there.
You got it, champ. You got it.